I come to you from Matthew chapter 5, verse 38, verse 39, 40, 41, 42, and up to verse 48. And I want you to participate in this word by reading it, digesting what the Lord is saying. You have heard that it has been said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. That's the kind of world in which we are living in now. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. You heard me? I'm going to hit you back. You hurt my family, I'm coming, I'm going to hurt your family. You don't give me anything, so I'm not going to give you anything back. You get me angry, so I'm going to retaliate with anger as well. But Jesus has come, and he has upset that proverbial apple cart. He has brought in a new paradigm of attitudes, which we shall display one to the other. Matthew chapter 5, verse 38. I want to do this expositorily this morning. It's changed the status quo. He said, it is not true in my kingdom that you should render evil for evil. He said, I want you to put up a fight against the very thought and the very notion that you should return in kind evil. Do not ever turn evil back with evil. Instead, he said, if someone slaps you on one side of the cheek, do not retaliate with anger. Turn the other cheek and say, get me on the next side now. This must be a shift in ideas. Shift in perspective. But it's radical in that when we do this, there will be no retaliation. When a person sees that you are willing to let him hit the other side, they will soon find themselves saying, this guy's got to be crazy. And this can have the effect of calming things down. I'm talking to you this morning. If a man says that he's going to sue you, take you to court, when you get that summons in your hands, you never received a summons to attend the court, you will not understand what I'm saying. But if you have received a summons, you know that when you get that summons, it does something to you. You lose it, you lose your peace temporarily, and you got to regain it quickly. Many years ago, someone served not only one summons on me, not only two summons on me, not only three summons on me, but several summons on me. And every time I got those summons, I was minded to try and I was thinking about what I could do to this person. But because of who I was and who I was related to in terms of my salvation, something keep telling me, calm down, this too will pass. So if they sue you to the court, the Bible says that if they want to take your coat, tell them, don't only take my coat, take the coat too. There's no fight about this thing. You know, the whole idea Jesus is saying, do not put too much emphasis on material possessions. Do not allow your material possessions to determine who you truly are. Because when they are taken from you, they are the only props that you have. When they are removed from you, it means that your self-esteem will plummet and go to rock bottom. Do not build your life on the external. Do not strengthen the things which people can see. God wants us to strengthen the things that they cannot see. May I tell you this morning that every last thing, one of the problems that you've had, every setback that you've experienced, every delay that you've had, even if it's just as you're going out, you forget your keys, and you can't find your keys. Remember that that delay was a delay that was necessary to bring you on the equilibrium that you ought to have for your destiny. You could not get beyond that point until you found your keys. When you found your keys, you said, I was delayed. But God says, no, I've just brought you on time so that your destiny will be where it ought to be, and that it will not leave you behind, and that you will not be before it. We've got to see every setback, every trial, every tribulation is God softening us, preparing us for that eternal hope. That day when these sickly shores will know us no more. It is God telling us, beware, enjoy yourself, because tomorrow you will be in a better place than this. It is God stirring the circumstances of our nests to let us know that this is not our resting place. This world is not our home. We only bury graveyard troubles, pitching or moving tent in our home every day. So my friends, this morning, if someone asks you to go a mile, go with them 2 miles. If someone asks you to borrow something, don't say no. I'm guilty. I sure you are too. But do you realize that as we come to the crux of this expository word, you will find that when a person comes and asks you to lend you something or to borrow something from you, this could be the very person that you need to help. See, the Bible tells us that you have heard that it was said by them of old that you must love your neighbor.